On Wednesday, January 19, 2011, Delaware State welcomed Dr. Ian Smith in the Martin Luther King Student Center. Dr. Smith spoke about small tips to achieve a healthier and longer life, as well as the thinking processes that everyone must go through in order to make these tips work. Dr. Smith is a medical expert who has appeared on shows such as Oprah, The View, The Tyra Banks Show, and even Larry King. He's currently the regular medical contributor on The Rachel Ray Show and VH1 Celebrity Fit Club. He's also the creator of the 50 Million Pound Challenge. WDSU had a chance to speak with Dr. Ian Smith before he shared his expertise with the campus.
But I want to inspire people, students and faculty, by the way, whoever's in attendance. I want them to kind of be inspired to think about the vision of what they're going to be like and what they aspire to, the legacy they're going to leave behind, what kind of challenges they're going to undertake as they grow. And no one's too old to take on challenges. I mean, the beauty of life is that you can never learn everything, you can never do everything. So there's always another challenge around the corner. I want the students in particular to focus on their intellectual curiosity, their political curiosity, their historical curiosity, and get students to kind of start formulating how they think. Not about particular issues, but to learn how to think. You know, sometimes, you know, we never think about thinking. And I want students to think about how they look at issues. Do they look at both sides of the issues? Are they asking the right questions? So the idea of a future you is, what do you want yourself to be? And what steps do you need to take to fulfill that dream of yours? Freshman 15 is a misnomer. The average freshman does not gain 15 pounds. They gain between 5 and 8 pounds. And believe it or not, women are not the mostly victimized by the freshman 15. Men are. So men actually typically gain more weight, but we always think of women gaining that freshman 15, and it's just this misperception that is perpetrated, unfortunately. The 50 million pound challenge was kind of my answer to what I thought was the call across the country to get America to focus on health and losing weight. 67% of Americans are overweight. Diabetes is growing out of control. We expect in the next 50 years for half the population to be almost diabetic or pre-diabetic. And so the challenge, we call it the challenge, was about getting people the information they need, giving them the inspiration they need, and giving them the resources for free online, because the world is online now, but to get them to start incorporating some of these healthy behavioral issues into their life. We've signed up almost 2 million people. We've lost almost 6 million pounds. But beyond the numbers, and numbers are fun to talk about, but beyond the numbers, it's the individual stories that we hear of people who are now not on diabetes medications anymore. They've lost half their body weight. They're able to walk more. They've helped their heart disease. And obesity and health diseases are largely non-discriminatory. And so, you know, overweight people and people who suffer from those problems are of all shapes, sizes, ethnicities, and political affiliations. And so that's why it's such a varied and eclectic existence on the website, because this is something we all face.
Okay.
So my new book in April is going to be called EAT, E-A-T, that's it. And the idea behind it is it's the no diet diet book. Diets don't work for everyone. I've written diet books. And some people have been very successful on them, but some people just are not amenable to rigid programs. So in this book, EAT, it teaches people how to make smarter decisions physically and nutritionally to get the results that they want without the pressure of having to follow a rigid plan. And it gives them the kind of flexibility they need to be able to choose what works for them, food preferences, but it gives you really the basic foundation to make these smart decisions, whether in a restaurant, a fast food restaurant, or in a grocery store.
All of us here at Delaware State University thanks Dr. Smith for taking time out of his busy schedule. We wish Dr. Ian Smith good luck on his book and promoting the 50 Million Pound Challenge. For now, back to WDSU TV.